While he's barely spent half a year at Paris Saint-Germain, there's already talk about Lionel Messi returning to Barcelona very soon. The Argentine is not really enjoying life in the French capital and is reportedly already plotting his next move. And the veteran forward's priority is to trace back his footsteps to where it all started for him. Tons of clubs around Europe are eager to snap up Jonathan David, but as we all know, there will only be one winner. Who will get the Canadian striker's signature? Ansu Fati had been doing really well of late, but it appears that the young forward is set to miss a few more months out of action. Wow, the kid can't catch a break, can he? One of the biggest news items of the month revolves around Erling Haaland's agent Mino Raiola, whose current health condition is going to impact the young Norwegian's future at the club. Remember Mario Balotelli? Well, the once controversial striker has turned over a new leaf and is doing well. And it appears that the change of attitude has helped him to get closer to returning to the Italian national side. Joao Felix and Diego Simeone are not seeing eye to eye, and it appears that the young forward is likely to leave the club this summer. Before we get started, we want to share the sponsor of today's video. The OneFootball app is the ultimate football platform and is a must-have for every football fan, so that you can follow all of your favorite leagues, teams, and players all the time right from your phone. You can be sure to turn on notifications for specific players to be instantly alerted when they score a goal or when they are involved in other breaking news. It is the best and easiest way to stay up to date with everything football. Click the link in the description down below to download the app right now. You won't regret it. Joao Felix wants to leave, and Cholo wants him to leave. The words used by Javier Matallanas, journalist for Diario AS and regular contributor to Cadena SER, are strong, but sum up the extremely tense situation which currently hovers between the Portuguese striker and his coach, Diego Simeone. The most expensive player in the club's history, Joao Felix, has asked to leave in January. Asked about the subject, Diego Simeone recently affirmed, in this sense, that he always understood everything and that he was open to everything. Today, it's clear that the divorce between the two men seems total. In the midst of a crisis in terms of results, the Rojiblancos sit fourth in La Liga, 16 points behind Real Madrid and recently eliminated from the Copa del Rey, and they're indeed struggling to find the right recipe collectively. Worrying defensively and out of ideas offensively, Atletico are sinking weekend after weekend into crisis, and one wonders if the players in the current squad are really compatible with the philosophy of the former Argentine international. The question seems in any case legitimate for Joao Felix. Hampered by injuries last August and with only four starts in La Liga since the start of the season, the former Benfica player thus presents an almost blank statistical line which reads 3 goals and 3 assists in 19 matches in all competitions. Numbers that are far below expectations for a player who's way too talented. And it appears that Simeone thinks that Joao Felix was a mistake. Let me explain that a little. Everyone knew that Felix is not really a Diego Simeone type of player. He tried to mold him like he did with Antoine Griezmann to run and defend, but the players don't understand and is one of those who likes to stay away from defensive responsibilities. Targeted for his inability to find solutions and regularly tackled for his misuse of the players he has available, Diego Simeone does not seem to be in danger yet. But this situation should still largely favour the starting desires of the Portugal international, who could have signed for Manchester City. Struggling with the style of play used by the Argentine tactician, Joao Felix could take his undeniable talent to other European teams, and there's no doubt that he will not be short of options. More than 3.5 years after his last appearance for Italy, Mario Balotelli is about to make his return to the national side. Roberto Mancini wants to give him a chance during a preparatory course for the World Cup playoffs. "I would leave Turkey on foot now if I knew I would be in the Italian team in March." Some had taken Balotelli for a madman when, on a live Twitch session last November, he declared that he still wanted to return to the national team. As incredible as it might seem, the striker is on his way to winning an unlikely bet. According to information from Sky Sport Italia, he will be called up by Mancini to reward him for his great season with Adana Demirspor, where he has 7 goals, 2 assists in 18 Super League matches. The coach is preparing to organize a few friendly games at the end of January with the objective of preparing for the playoffs for the World Cup, scheduled for March. The Squadra Azzurra will have a lot to do because they find themselves in the same pot as Portugal for a possible final on March 29th. Before that, they will have to face North Macedonia 5 days earlier. Whoever loses will miss one of the last two European champions at the World Cup in Qatar, organized at the end of the year from November 21st to December 18th. For a few days, and in particular following the serious injury to Federico Chiesa, Mancini has been preparing his move, while the announcement should be made official very soon. The coach contacted the 31-year-old striker in mid-January to test the waters and call him up for selection, 3.5 years after his last match for the Azzurri, which was against Poland. It was not necessary to say it twice to the former Marseille man, who immediately answered positively. But beware, this is only an internship for the moment. These few training sessions will allow Mancini to see where the Italian international is physically and mentally. It is then that the final call will be made, whether he will feature at the playoffs or not. The opportunity is great for Super Mario, but terribly risky for him as well as for the coach, especially in the event of failure to qualify for the World Cup, where the player would be involved. Less than a year after the victory at the Euros, Italy have to continue on the good work that they've done under Mancini. Maybe Balotelli can help them. Injured and substituted while in tears during the defeat against Athletic Bilbao in the round of 16 of the Copa del Rey, Ansu Fati suffered from an injury to the proximal tendon of the left hamstring. Another setback for the Barcelona winger, who, according to the latest medical examinations, could miss several months of action with Barcelona. Fate is hounding Ansu Fati. Forced to leave that game early against Athletic Bilbao, the young Spanish international striker has not been spared physical glitches since the start of his young career. If you remember, Fati had damaged his meniscus in November 2020 against Betis. A new setback for the Barcelona starlet, who just returned from a hamstring injury contracted at the end of November, which could this time prove to be much more serious than expected, if we're to believe the verdict handed down by the Catalan club after the latest medical examinations carried out on Friday evening. The tests have shown that the youngster's injury will take some time to heal. The club has also advised the youngster to have another surgery, which will put him on the shelf for at least 3 months. This means that Barcelona might be forced to take Ousmane Dembélé off the transfer list. The Frenchman has been decent this season, and in Fati's absence, he will have a chance to help his club secure a top-four finish, even though he's likely to leave them as a free agent next summer. The future of Erling Haaland is on everyone's lips during the transfer window. Courted by the biggest European teams, the serial scorer of Borussia Dortmund is beginning to get annoyed by the pressure put on him by his leaders, at a time when his agent Mino Raiola is encountering serious health problems, a situation that could also completely change the current scenario, according to the Spanish media. On the 12th of January, the news of the emergency hospitalization of super agent Mino Raiola caused a number of reactions. The clan of the player representative then calmed things down by saying that it was only a planned visit. However, the latest information revealed by Bild told that the state of health of the representative of Erling Haaland had deteriorated further. It is a lung condition unrelated to the virus, reported the German media. Yesterday afternoon, Mediaset Sport pointed out that Raiola had been released after spending several hours in intensive care. But this worrying news could, despite everything, rock the future of the Norwegian giant. Since Raiola has only recently been released, doctors have advised him to take things slowly, and he would definitely not be visiting people for hours anytime soon. It takes a lot of time to get a transfer done, so we expect some delay in whatever latest news we read up on Erling Haaland and even Paul Pogba. While he was forced to leave Barcelona, Messi harbors no ill will towards the club. Circumstances were such that there was no other option. And while he's on a 2-year deal with PSG, Messi doesn't exactly look like a happy fella. Eventually, he'll want to return to Camp Nou, and it appears that Messi is actually planning something for sure. If you look at things, Messi will consider his future if PSG don't win the Champions League this season. The Parisians are desperate to win the trophy, and if they don't do it this season, the likes of Kylian Mbappe and a few others will be questioning the project. In case it happens, Messi will definitely not want to be a part of the team in transition. At his age, Messi wants to win, so he might end up biding his time and decide not to sign an extension. On the other hand, Messi might want to find a way and terminate his deal in France and move back to Barcelona. He'll have to make a few financial compromises, but as long as he's happy to be back in familiar surroundings, it won't be that much of a problem. Again, it's just a theory.